It's my pleasure to introduce our next speaker, Mary Matthiesen. And it's been such a pleasure to work with her on planning this conference. She has so many ideas of different tools and practical tools for you to bring back to your work to use. Mary Matthiesen is the Community Engagement and Education Director with Mission Hospice and Home Care in San Mateo, one of the original and still independent nonprofit hospices in California. She has led awareness initiatives on end-of-life issues internationally and supports the innovative educational offerings at Mission Hospice, as well as her passion of engaging partners to co-create more compassionate communities for those living with serious illness, death, and bereavement. Let's welcome Mary Matthiesen.
Thank you, Pauline, and thank you all. I know it's late in the afternoon after a phenomenal series of speakers, and I want to just acknowledge with you this moment. It's a long time coming, but it is groundbreaking today that we are talking together about Alzheimer's and advanced care planning and end-of-life care on the same podium. 15 to 20 years from now, we will look back and know that this was revolutionary. And some of us who have been working in these fields for at least 30 years, as I have, are so excited that today is actually a new day. So thank you for being part of this. I got a little Oprah on there, didn't I? So my role with you this afternoon is to actually put some of this into practice for you with some tools that you can take back. And before I begin, I just want to take a show of hands. How many of you work with patients and families while they're still very well or early diagnosis? How many in the room? We all do. How many of you in the room right at diagnosis? Of dementia, Alzheimer's dementia. How many of you are caring for patients and families with severe dementia? How many of you are caring for patients at the end of life? Do you look around the room? How many of you were born? This conversation that we are having with the numbers of projected numbers for expansion of dementia is a conversation that I, working in the end-of-life arena, am having with people on a daily basis. The need for advanced care planning for people with dementia is a need for people who were born. Dementia is not the reason for an advanced directive or to talk about end-of-life wishes, but it certainly promotes the urgency for people's concerns and needs to get started. And how many of you have had the conversation with family members when it was too late? Their family member had not told them what they wanted. They had no clue what their priorities or place of care wishes would be, and the stressors that put on the family as well as the care team. That's what we have an opportunity to prevent. So my role with you now is to go through the number one reason that those conversations don't take place. And that is because no one brings it up. Family members don't start the conversation. Physicians don't start the conversation. Care home staff don't start the conversation. Nurses, a lot of times nurses and social workers will do their best to start the conversation, but still statistically it is not happening nearly enough, and there are lots of tools to help you begin. So my presentation is about preparing yourself by becoming more familiar with some of the tools from a personal perspective so that you can further engage those in your care. Some of them will be more appropriate to work with patients at different levels and stages of care, but we wanted to introduce you with some practical tools you could take back with you. So the first tool that has magically appeared on your tables is a deck of cards. Everyone, someone at each table, hold up the deck of cards. This is a heavily choreographed session, so I really need to, my living room is expanded to 700 people, so thank you. So if you have the deck of cards on their table, I'd like you, someone at the table, open up the deck of cards and place all of them out on the table face up. We got one level of plastic off of them, but not the second. That's the first test. Get the plastic off the card. And here's your question. There's lots you can do with these, but here's your question for this session. If you had to tell someone today what three things would matter most for your care at the end of life, look at the phrases on the cards and take a minute to notice and write down the three that would matter most to you. Don't pick them up because then they're not there for your table mates. Turn them so you can see them. You can write them down, the three that would matter most to you if you had to tell someone today. Has everyone had a chance to look at and choose? No. Couple more minutes. The wild card, for any of you that are seeing the wild card, if you've always known there's something that really matters to you, to taste chocolate until the last moment you can taste it, to have a rock star funeral plan, to make sure your pet's cared for, something that's not on the other cards, that's your wild card. So has everyone had a chance to get a sense if there's one, two, or three cards that would matter to you? You've got a couple that would matter. Just let me ask the room, when you saw those cards, I know it's hard with people talking, when you saw those cards, how many of you knew something on those cards, some of those phrases mattered? So I just want to go through a couple of exercises with these. If you're willing, this is completely voluntary, and I'm going to promise you that I will rudely interrupt you in a minute and a half. So I want you to know that from the outset. This is an exercise just for the practice here while we're in the room. But if you're willing, turn to someone at your table, the person next to you, and for no more than a minute, give them a couple sentences about why you chose one of the cards, and then switch partners so you both can do that. I'm just going to give you 3 minutes total. I wasn't a school teacher in the past, but I think I remember that thing. That's my favorite part of this exercise, because there's clearly nothing to talk about, is there? Advanced care planning is first and foremost about a conversation. It's about multiple conversations. It's about engaging with people about what matters most. And that is the intersection between all care and end-of-life care, is starting that conversation. The tool that you just used is called Go Wish. It was developed by the CODA Alliance, which is an end-of-life and palliative care consortium in Santa Clara County. I was fortunate to work on a white paper with them when they first had the Archstone Foundation funding to develop the card game based on research published by Steinhauser about the key wishes that people had facing the end of life. And those 36 phrases came up time and time again. There are a gazillion things you can do with that deck of cards. The one couple of questions I'd just like to ask of you, I know that was very rushed, and I know that some of you are living with a lot of your own personal concerns or caring for loved ones or even living with your own diagnosis. It can be emotional to look at those cards. How many of you it was emotional to take a look at this? This is emotional business. Staff are often really concerned that they're going to upset someone by starting this conversation. It's upsetting. It's okay. We're talking about the real deal of some of the most intimate, personal, important, significant things that matter for someone, as my mother said, the last birthday party. The last thing you get to plan. But because it's emotional, people avoid it. How many of you are likely to get the care you want at the end of your life if no one knows those three things that you just chose and spoke about? How likely is it that what you just chose will happen if no one else knows it? And for people with dementia, for any of us, the goal isn't to have three. The goal isn't to have one. The goal is to have everything that matters to us, if at all possible. But how many of those things are possible if you wait till the last days or hours of someone's life, or in the case of dementia, until they have no capacity to communicate what matters most? So I hit this home hard because you have to convince yourself first that it matters to open this conversation with the people you care for. It's about love. It's about care. And it's not going to be easy. If it ever gets too easy, you're probably in the wrong business. But for family members, and myself included, honoring both my parents' wishes at the end of their lives, the phrases that we use about it's a gift to your loved ones is no joke. And the care that's possible when staff can align to knowing what matters most to a patient as well as the family, that's coordinated care. That is not only patient-centered care, but new phrases called network-centered care. And it's only possible if we start these conversations. So that's tool number one. The tool number one that's on your tables, the Go Wish cards, were fortunately for all of us donated by CODA Alliance. They are a nonprofit in the county. They donate a pack for each table. And my gift to you through CODA is to offer that you get to choose at your table, but my request of you is who takes that pack home. My request is the person who's going to commit to starting the conversation with their own family by taking the deck home with them tonight or this week. And you will have the guilt of all your table mates if you do not start that conversation. So, if for now, because of time, if you would just put the cards aside, we can answer questions more about them. And like I said, there is a lot more about them. The one thing that I will say for working with patients with dementia, if patients are near the end of life or have any cognitive decline, tendency toward confusion, there are way too many cards. There are way too many choices. But the fact that you know those phrases, you might have one in your mind to open a conversation with. They are conversation starters. They are not a tick box list. The second tool that I want to introduce to you, Barack generously introduced earlier, was the conversation starter kit. And some of you aren't aware, but in these phenomenal packs that were put together for you for the conference, on the left-hand side of your purple pack are a set of handouts. And in the back of one of the yellow sections is something called your conversation starter kit. This is also, the one thing about the Go Wish cards, CODA gave us some order forms. We have them at the Mission Hospice table in the back corner. So if you are interested in ordering them through CODA, there's information there. The conversation starter kit builds on the cards with the phrases about wishes and values for a patient or family member, and was specifically designed to work with patients and families with dementia. They have a standard starter kit for advanced care planning in general, and they have a specific starter kit for patients with dementia. I'm just going to call your attention. I'm assuming if you found your way to this conference, you can read this document for yourself. But on page 4, there's a paragraph, the second paragraph down, having the conversation about care, and especially care at the end of life, isn't an intrusion or unkind. On the contrary, it may be the most intimate way to promise your loved one that you will be there for them, they or their caregivers. It's one of the big concerns that family members have. I also want to call, your attention to the entire document, but just so that you can get a sense of what's in it. One of the key focus areas of this document, on pages 7 and 8, are some simple where I stand scales. So once you've started with your key, what matters most to you at the end of life on page 8, you've just had an example of some ways to explore that with the Go Wish cards. As a patient, I'd like to know everything or nothing. As doctors treat me, I would like to have the doctors think what they do best, or have a say in every decision. Next page, when it comes, how involved do you want your loved ones to be in your care? So these are stepwise, simple questions that people can start to assess, and you can start to assess with them how they want their care to be handled, what matters to them. There are also steps in the back of this guide of how it can be used on page 12 upon diagnosis, in the mid stages of an illness, or in the later stages of the disease with family members. There are suggestions on gathering families, holding family discussions around this. And there are videos on the website at Conversation Project and quotes from family members and staff who have used the guide with them. But again, if you don't know what's in it, it's hard to share that with others. So take a read through it, practice it for yourself. If everyone in the room started this conversation and completed their advanced directives, we would have 700 fewer circles of families ready for what we're trying to do with our patients and family members. And the final tool that I just want to introduce to you is in the back of your purple pack. It's this Take Charge Advanced Care Planning Toolkit. Step 1, the Go Wish cards, or something about wishes and values, what matters most. Step 2, what's important for your care, in the conversation starter kit. These aren't necessarily steps, but tool 3, the Take Charge Toolkit, we have included in your packs from Mission Hospice and Home Care and the amazing organizations that we've been working with around the county who have partnered with us to raise the profile of this conversation across our community before the doctor's office. With inspiration from, and we use all of these tools in free public workshops, and have had tremendous feedback from the public about helping them to start this conversation first. This toolkit is available for you to download for free. The website is on the bottom of the toolkit. All of the agencies that we've been working together in the county, many of our sponsors of today's event, are on the back of the booklet as well. But the very simple steps of advanced care planning, of thinking about what matters most, talking about your wishes with your family and loved ones, most important on advanced directives or for patients with dementia, choosing your healthcare agent, step 3 is in here. And step 3 is on page 5. Step 4, writing it down, talking about an advanced directive and the pulsed form, and making copies, making sure your doctor, your healthcare agent, your family, those in your circle of care. I would completely agree this is a conversation to get medical advice from the medical community, not the legal community. And yet the legal aspects of it, you'll hear about in a few moments as well, which are also very significant. And the final page, now what? All of our goal in national initiatives is to get this conversation started earlier. So we have the rinse and repeat cycle at the end. And many people who have come to our workshops are realizing that they actually had completed an advance directive 10 years ago, and it's in a safe deposit box someplace. And they're realizing they need to bring it out and update it based on current medical information and current information about the field. Three tools for you. I had no PowerPoint, the green button you've been hearing about all day. I saved myself from that, but I hand it off to you. You are the green button in this conversation. Please take these tools, convince yourself and your teams to start the conversation. Have exercises with them about these tools and others. We are starting decades late to get this conversation linked up with dementia, and it's really important that we continue to learn and grow this conversation together, not as something that's a death sentence or a diagnosis, but a care plan based on love and what matters most to those we're caring for. Thank you.